In this tutorial, we will draw and animate this drawing effect using Grease Pencil. Hi, I'm Dantti and let's get started. Start Blender with 2D animation. If you wanna go faster, go to Preferences and make sure you have Tap for Pie menu enabled. Now set the stroke strength to 1, tweak the size and change the colors. Draw a line that you want to animate. I'm going to use the tutorial text from the intro. Switch into object mode and select your stroke object. Convert it to a Bezier curve from the object panel. Select the new lines object and tap into edit mode. We need to connect possible gaps for the animation, so press F key until everything is connected. But don't press it too many times to make a circle. We can extrude the start and ending curves for our hand animation. Now tap into object mode and select the original grease pencil object. Go to modifiers and add a build modifier. Tweak the animation time and possible delay. If you want to add a drying effect, add the thickness modifier, set the thickness factor to 1 and play with the custom curve until you're happy. Next, you wanna add a blank grease pencil object. Select and tap into draw mode. Add materials and draw your hand and pen. Use layers, they make everything better. And maybe know how to draw, have a reference or something. Add some effort to make it nice. Now tap into object mode and add an empty plane axis. Select the grease pencil object and in frame 1, tap into edit mode. Make sure the tip of the pen is in the center of the empty. You can adjust this later at frame 1 if you want. Tap into object mode. Drag your grease pencil object on top of the empty while holding shift. Select the empty and go to object constraints. Add a follow path, select the lines object and press animate path. Press G key and move the empty to the start of the stroke animation. You can hide the hand object from the outliner if it gets in the way. Now we need to tweak the animation. Select the lines object and go to curve settings and path animation. You can first try playing with the frame count you set to the build modifier, but if you have text, the gaps we filled before are going to cause trouble. So let's clear evaluation time keyframes and switch to dope sheet. Be sure to change the interpolation to linear at the timeline with the T shortcut. Go to frame 1, set the evaluation time to 0 and add a keyframe. Now scroll the timeline forward and add new keyframes to evaluation time to match the animation. You can also add some effects like shadows and rim lights to your hand and text animations. You can find them at the effects menu. You're done! See you next time!